In a previous video, I compared different motor types to find out which one is best suited as a generator, and came to the conclusion that BLDC motors are the best option. But due to their rather high kV rating, which basically describes how fast they need to be rotated in order to output 1 volt as a generator, they cannot easily be utilized for low RPM applications, like a hand crank generator. That is why I recommended to add a gearbox to the motor, to increase the rotation speed of it while still applying a low RPM on the outside. But a viewer stated that such a gearbox would introduce more power losses, which I do agree with. And he also stated that rewinding the BLDC motor would be the best solution to lower the kV rating. So in this video, I will follow his advice and show you how you can disassemble and rewind a BLDC motor successfully to use it more easily as a low RPM generator. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. One fact about them. JLC PCB's intelligent factory system monitors the temperature, humidity, status, and working data of every machine in their factories. Upload your global files to order high-quality PCBs for low prices. First off, we have to disassemble the motor. But since I have never done that before, I did a test run with a smaller BLDC motor I had lying around. After securing it in a benchwise, I removed its snap ring and washer with a flathead screwdriver. Then I simply pulled its rotor upwards to remove it. And thus, we are already very close to the stator that we want to rewind. But sadly, no matter how hard I tried removing it from its metal mount, it never wanted to let go. That is why I clamped it in my benchwise and fired up my blowtorch. With it, I slowly and carefully heated up the whole construction, and afterwards cooled down the inner metal part rapidly with coolant spray. This way, I was able to pull out the stator mount, and thus freed the stator from its motor prison. And since that technique turned out to be a success, I followed the same steps for the bigger BLDC motor. Now removing the rotor was once again no problem, but the heating slash cooling technique I utilized before was, as you can see, not enough to remove the stator. That is why I tried twisting the stator mount and afterwards the stator itself, which was not successful either. Then I tried adding a bolt, washer and nut construction to the motor and hammering the inner metal parts out of the stator, which was also not successful. Last but not least though, through a lot of heat and force, I was able to turn the stator upwards and remove it from its metal mounts. And after also removing the bolt construction along with all the ball bearings that broke during my operation, I have to say that the damaged stator mount, as well as the stator itself, were still usable. So next, I untwisted the 3 output wires of the stator, which resulted in a total of 6 individual strands of wires. That of course makes sense when you consider that such a motor consists of 3 coils. And after tinning the ends of those 6 wire strands with solder, I utilized my multimeter with its resistance measurements to find out how the coils of the motor were wired up. Now, remember how I said in the motor type generator video that the BLDC motor was wired up in a star connection? Well, that was incorrect. As it turns out, according to my measurements, the coils were actually connected in a delta configuration. Now of course, at this point, we could rewire them to a star connection to change a couple of properties of the motor, but let's save this fun for later. For now, let's rather unwind the coil wires from the stator, which for the first phase was actually not that hard to do. But the second and third phase was a complete nightmare to unwind, due to the tons of adhesive the manufacturer utilized to keep the windings in place. But nevertheless, after an hour of applying brute force, I got my mostly undamaged naked stator core. Now by having a closer look at the coil wires of one motor phase, we might be able to find out how we have to alter our new coil wires in order to decrease the kV rating. After cutting the complete strand, I counted a total of 26 individual enamel copper wires with a diameter of 0.2 mm each. And while unwinding the wires from the stator, I actually counted a total of 9 turns per pole, so a total of 36 turns per phase. Since the diameter and number of parallel wires only determines the resistance of the wire, it has to be the number of turns that determines the kV rating. To prove it, think of the formula for the induction voltage, which is proportional to the number of turns, which makes sense from the generator side of view. And from the motor side of view, we can say that with more turns, we got a higher back electromotive force, which opposes the rotation of the motor, and thus we get a lower RPM and thus kV rating. So in a nutshell, increasing the number of turns will increase the induction voltage and decrease the kV rating. For a first test, I went with a new turn ratio of 27 per pole, so 108 in total, which will hopefully result in a third of the original kV rating. Also, I will be using a single 0.5 mm enameled copper wire, simply because I had quite a lot of it laying around. Now while I was marking numbers onto my stator poles, I was starting to wonder in which manner I'm supposed to wind the coils. And luckily for me, I found a BLDC motor kit, that you can of course purchase, but more importantly, it comes with a manual that showcases perfectly how you have to wind each motor phase. So according to those guidelines, I started winding, which was a bit complicated at first, but once I got to the third motor phase, it was a very easy task to do, only a bit repetitive. And just like that, I got my newly wound stator with its 6 coil wires, whose varnish I removed from their tips, tint them with a bit of solder, and afterwards marked which wire represents the start and end of each coil, according to the manual. After then grabbing some brand new ice-cold ball bearings and inserting them into the slightly damaged stator mount, I added a bit of two-component adhesive to it as well and slid the finished stator onto it. Once the glue was dry, I guided the 6 wires through the enclosure's opening and finally reinserted the rotor, which means our modified BLDC motor or generator was complete. For first tests, I connected the 6 wires to one another, like it is stated here, in order to create a delta connection. After then hooking the resulting connections up to an ESC and powering everything, it was clear that as soon as the motor started rotating, that our modification was successful. But did we really achieve a kV rating of 90? Well, by utilizing 15 volts, the motor reached a maximum RPM of 1620, which is pretty close to the value we were aiming for. And as a comparison, the original motor reached an RPM of 4740 at 15 volts, which is close to its advertised 270 kV value. Last but not least, I connected the newly wound motor to another motor to connect its output wires to a 6-pulse Brückenschaltung in order to properly use it as a generator. As you can see, at an almost constant ERPM of 2840 of the motor, we get peaks of around 4.26 volts on the generator outputs, while the original wound motor would only have delivered around 1.4 volts at the same RPM. But we can do even better than this with the new windings. By tying the endpoints of the coils together and connecting the start points to the 6-pulse Brückenschaltung, we get peak voltages of around 7.5 volts at the same RPM, which is 1.76 times as much than before. The reason is that the star connection reduces the KV rating by the factor of the root of 3 in comparison to the delta configuration. But then again, the star connection also gives us less amps and overall power, so both wiring methods have their advantages. And if you want to learn even more about BLDC motors and their mechanical and electrical properties, then I highly recommend checking out the Instructables article that is linked in the video description. But anyway, I'm quite happy with the result of my rewinding, and I hope that I can use this knowledge in future projects to create some custom motors slash generators. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned a thing or two as well. If so, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!